I said good day, sir!
Welcome back, everybody. It's your coverage of the defense for our final set of the night, where we'll have the two-game series at VirtusPro going up against Absolute Legends. We've, of course, gone into Group B, and let's, without any further ado, jump ourselves directly into the game. VirtusPro will be on the dire side for this game. Over on the radiant side, Absolute Legends. Over on my side is my co-commentator, the capitalist. Welcome back to the broadcast, man.
Thanks, man. This is a good game to end on. VirtusPro versus Absolute Legends. I'm glad to hear that Absolute Legends is still able to make it through the defense. I think they got a lot of potential, and this should be a good test of that.
Yeah, they had some problems last night. Miggle was basically studying for one of his big exams, so he was unable to play last night in Unicorn. I'm still unsure about this, but he cut himself on onions was the quoting of it. So I'm pretty sure he used a knife with cutting onions and then cut himself and was unable to play. That is what I assume to be the case. But they are both here this evening in Absolute Legends. They have their full roster, and they're going to need it, man. They're going to need it. Up against VirtusPro, but then again, VirtusPro, they lost their first game of the night. They lost their first game to Next.KZ. Wasn't looking good. And now in this game, they're giving a wisp to Mania. I'm hoping NS has a good plan, because they were shaking in game number one up against Next.KZ. They looked really, really good in game number two. Crazy had a fantastic game on his puck. But NS, I'm wondering if he thought the Mania wouldn't take the bait in this one. I'm really wondering if he thought that was the case. The case is most definitely wrong if that's the case.
You know, the Wisp mid-game aggression, being able to globally gank at any point in time, you know what that works really well with? Slark.
Yeah.
So that mid-game carry Slark, that's going to be roaming around the map, trying to get as many kills as possible. You throw in a good CK with Wisp, who's farming up those side lanes. At any point in time, they can react to Slark's movement and assist him in getting kills, maybe enforce some sort of team fight. You've got some signature heroes that you're giving way to Absolute Legends, potentially, and I'm excited to see it. VirtusPro, they opt to take it quite a while, actually, for their first two picks, thinking long and hard. I mean, there are different ways to deal with a Wisp, right? So your initial picks are really important. How exactly are you going to go in aggressive tri-lane? If they go dual lanes, how are you going to respond to that? You know, those sort of questions about what you're going to do in the mid-game are really, really important for your first initial pick. So VirtusPro, think long and hard about that. End up going for Leshrac. That's a little bit more aggressive than I was imagining, but they've got some good AoE stuns that are potentially really strong versus Wisp. They have, I don't think they're going to. They have a potential for an aggressive tri-lane, but I doubt it. Unless they go something really aggressive, like, both of them already banned out. Lifestealer and Gyrocopter were banned out by Absolute Legends. So I don't think VirtusPro, without either one of those two really aggressive tri-lane heroes, I don't think they can really go an aggro try. But we'll have to see.
This is a VirtusPro, man. What you think they can't do, they will do. This is just...
They'll make it work.
Yeah, basically. Basically. Like, with this scenario, with a Wisp being picked up, I wouldn't be surprised if VP just say, you know what, AL, if you want to farm, go right ahead. You want a CK Wisp, go right ahead. CK wants to jump in, we'll throw him away with the Rubik. We'll do this kind of stuff. Then they'll be active about it. As opposed to like this other thing, like we saw Disruptor the other night trying to go up against a Wisp, and it actually wasn't too shabby the way it works. But it's a little bit more passive, and that's not what VP wanted. In fact, their third hero, again, another hero that doesn't care about like being like this kind of gank on. Chaos Knight throws a bolt out. If he's got refraction up, he'll probably be okay and can survive by himself. Rubik and Lashrank, two heroes with control. VP can actively change what happens on this map. That's what they're looking for.
Yeah, I think that's a really good pickup. I mean, picking into the Darkseer, you know, it just goes to show how strong of a pickup, how strongly VP feels about this Templar Assassin, because you're absolutely right. The right refraction could be huge. Being able to dodge that big Chaos Bolt, that's a lot of damage to be negated. Darkseer, they could have two Legends here. They have some serious options. They can go dual lane versus Templar Assassin, who's presumably going to be middle. They can also Darkseer middle instead of the traditional suicide lane, have Wisp Chaos Knight, maybe even additional support in bottom. But both teams have a lot of options available to them. They're going to try and ban out VP, taking away some of those really strong supports that work well with Chaos Knight. Visage is going to be one of them. Just being able to make sure, I mean, since they've already picked up their Rubick Leshrac, I think that's what they're going to be focusing on. Meanwhile, Absolute Legends is taking away some of the potential carries that they don't want to deal with. Alchemist is too tanky for Wisp Chaos Knight to deal with effectively. And he isn't that he's strong versus Darkseer. He'd be a really good pickup for them. Puck, I'm a little interested to see. Just, I mean, I guess they just didn't want to have to deal with the control of Puck. But honestly, if I'm a Chaos Knight Wisp, I don't really care that much about a Puck.
Mm-hmm. If you're a Chaos Knight Wisp, yeah. Like, you're right, you wouldn't care. You wouldn't care at all. You just wait for him to come back out of his hiding spot, and then you'll nail him down. What we got else taken out? SD's gonna be the final ban out here from NS. So, I wouldn't have expected another passive support to come on from Absent Legends. I really wouldn't have expected that. Clockwork will be the pickup though, and considering Miguel is playing tonight, that's gonna be Clockwork going up against Templar Assassin in the middle lane. Which was Darkseer long, CK Wisp short, Weaver. Now gonna be VP's third pickup. A hero which has been played on the long lane as well as the safe lane by VirtusPro, so it's going to be very difficult to work for Mania to work out 100% what these lanes are going to be. But if I was going to be a gambling man, that's a safe lane Weaver. And it's a long lane Rubick Leshrac plus one.
Yeah.
That's why, like, you see DK, you see Alchemist come up, you're like, yeah. they're semi-aggressive heroes. DK setup stun would work nicely for Leshrac, wouldn't always require a Rubick. 5 seconds. Also, there's not a great thing when NS is currently DC'd out. Okay, now he came back in again. He keeps DC'ing during the draft and coming back in again. So I'm guessing he's a little bit unstable. His internet connection, not the player. NS is cool.
What I really like about VP's drafting is right now they have the options. They can go a tri-lane Weaver depending all on what Absolute Legends pick. If they pick some sort of jungler or a support that they feel is weak enough that they can go against it, they can go an aggro try. If not, I think that's what they're going to be doing is a defensive try with an Omni Knight suicide lane, potentially. Either that or some weird Omni Knight aggressive tri-lane. I don't know. We'll have to see. They've got options, but I'm presuming this is just an Omni Knight suicide lane. Just some sort of throwaway hero that's going to be able to really help them in the mid game. Significantly a strong versus Chaos Knight that bursts physical damage early on. Purification is going to be able to negate a lot of that damage that he outputs with his nukes. Later on, his ultimate is going to be able to really counter the Chaos Knight ultimate. Because while Chaos Knight, he does really good burst physical damage, it doesn't last forever, right? He depends heavily upon his ultimate. So those cooldowns are about the same, I think. Guardian Angel, 150-second cooldown versus 140-second cooldown. If you compare that in the late game with every single time Chaos Knight tries to use his Phantasm, you have successfully countered him. So Absolute Legends, they're going to have to go very, very aggressive here, I feel, with that pickup. And they're going to have a hard time locking down some of VP's hero. They've got some really good mobility in Weaver, as well as Templar Assassin, being able to meld at any point in time and blink away with that refraction. They're going to have a hard time shutting him down, and VP's looking to put this game long enough that Chaos Knight is no longer an issue.
That's a long time, man. And does that even work when CK is no longer an issue? You have to go like 50-minute plus game for CK to no longer be an issue.
I don't think so. Like, I honestly think that Guardian Angel is strong enough that when you have Chaos Knight as your one. Like, I'm not a big fan of Chaos Knight as a one in general, but when you have the Wisp behind you, you can make anything a one, right? Mm-hmm. But I really feel that last pick by VP is a strong enough hero, that ultimate is strong enough that they take away so much of Absolute Legends team fight when they take away that big Phantasm burst. And from there, that, you know, couple extra seconds that it takes you're going to see control come in. You're going to see them pretty much have won the team fights. Maybe some AoE will knock down an illusion or two or something like that. They will have won the team fight by the time that Chaos Knight is able to be effective again. But we'll have to see. I mean, lanes are an interesting problem for VirtusPro. That's the biggest thing, is lanes, if they come out of their laning phase weak, that's perfect for Absolute Legends. Like, if they are really suffering in their lanes, whatever they choose to do here, and Omni Knight doesn't have very good levels or anything like that, that's perfect setup for that with CK to run around ganking heroes, continue to snowball, and pushing down your racks before you're able to mount any sort of defense.
Yeah, but if VP get those levels, then it's going to be even Stevens for the CK. He'll jump in, try and initiate on somebody, then instantly there'll be a repel that will just stop him from doing everything, and life will be bad. Life would be worse if it was the new Omni Knight. Life would be a lot worse if it was the new Omni Knight.
Yeah, oh yeah. But you gotta stop bringing that up, Toby. I just want to talk about all about the different things about the
change. So do I, man. So do I. It looks like two guys that it's a low percentage chance that we'll be doing the talk show tonight.
It's too bad.
Yeah. A lot of people are still playing their games until very late in the evening. A lot of the Americans are also playing in the American Dota League, which is going on. So there's, a lot of games going on through that one. Brazil up against America and such. So, yeah.
You're going to try and just postpone it till tomorrow, maybe?
Then we're casting the defense till midnight.
Oh, man.
Four games tomorrow. Four games tomorrow for the defense. There's a lot of action. Tomorrow's schedule for the defense has VP versus Fnatic starting us off. Next.KZ play up against IC Cup. RoX.KIS versus Team Empire. And then Mouseballs versus Kieta. They're the four games for tomorrow. And then on Saturday, IC Cup VP. Next.KZ versus Fnatic. Let me just click some stuff and get us into the game. So Next.KZ versus Fnatic. On Saturday, Mouse, RoX.KIS, Fnatic, IC Cup. And then on the Sunday, we have AL versus NSKZ, Kieta versus Na'Vi, Na'Vi versus Empire, Empire versus Kieta. So almost all of the group stage matches from Group A and B, I believe, will be over by Sunday. Most of them. In fact, I believe that is the schedule, where we actually wrap up Group A, Group B by Sunday. So make sure you keep up to date with it all, guys. Right now, for the positioning of these teams, VirtusPro is in second position, tied up with Next.KZ. And Absolute Legends are sitting in fifth, 0-2 after their loss last night. But game's underway. Let's get ourselves started, man. We got CK running down the bottom lane. Again, like, Ryze is really pimped. even with, like, the rare mace, he's looking really good on that CK. But it's a five-man initiation from VP. They are going to look for an opening. The question is, can they find it? And Mania, he reveals it. They have no control. NSC.
They can fight this.
They might decide to. Ryze comes through. Iron Shell and big Light Strike Array. All five to be caught. The 1 second stun. It goes out Narsart, and he will be the first blood given over. A secondary Light Strike Array. It stops KSI. Oh, this is a complete disaster for VirtusPro. Miguel will be the only sacrifice for this one. But it's a double kill for Mania. A double kill for Miracle. There's no more mana left here for Ryze to throw out another bolt. And Illidan will escape on the bottom lane. Oh, that is the worst start VP could have asked for. We asked, like, would KSI have farm? Would all this kind of stuff happen? Would AL get a five-man light strike at Ray? Put that one in your compendium and smoke it.
What a play by Miracle. But not only, I think that was just the wrong decision by VirtusPro. I mean, they have the damage. They don't have a damage come out of Rubick. Leshrac stun, same as Lina stun. Weaver Shikuchi isn't that big. Honestly, Templar Assassin doesn't add much to 5-on-5 team fights at level 1. I honestly think that was just a really bad decision. Absolute Legends, meanwhile, they just had overwhelming advantage, especially with the Darkseer having a heads up, being able to get in at one Ion Shell good 5 seconds before the team fight even occurred. That way you can get a second one halfway through.
Mm-hmm.
That was just so big. Really well done And I think just really some tactical errors by VirtusPro. I'm interested to see, I've said this before, I'm not a big fan of Weaver aggressive tri-lanes. I think Weaver works really well tri-lane versus tri-lane, but in the safe lane where you have that room to move around with Shikuchi and get chases, you can trade a support hero and potentially pick up two just through the chasing that Weaver does. But they're also going up against a Wisp, which I've said before, it's a really good way to shut down Wisp, is aggro try against him. He's not the strongest support when you compare him to a lot of others. Omni Knight's going to be able to get some really good farm, safe lane versus Darkseer because of purification. He can survive in this lane just fine.
Yeah, he'll have no problems whatsoever. In fact, he's trying to get himself close enough as well. I don't know if he had the stick charges beforehand. He's got 6 stick charges up on himself at the moment for a lane where Darkseer just sits so far away. So every time Unicorn's going to come from, he'll have this extra burst to come back his way. But how was that CS? Didn't switch the board over. At this point, TIA's actually doing a really good job there in the middle lane. Up against Clockwork, it's still 8, like it's 8 for 5 up against 6 for 2. But every time I've come in here, Crazy keeping that aggression going on Miguel. Force him back a little bit, but the side blade damage, because he's not going to go meld level 1, there's no point in it. So he goes 2 points refraction, 1 point up in the side blades, and he keeps finding the right line to just tickle through all of this regeneration Miguel. And as I say that, bottles now come in. In fact, 2 of them. 1 for Unicorn, and 1 for Miguel.
Bottom. Illidan's gonna go down. And this is the problem, is the fact that while Wisp may not be the strongest tri-lane hero, oh, they're gonna keep going, yep. Getting more kills. This is just a complete disaster.
Arsad turns around, trying to get a little bit more. And, well, at this point, Wisp did take a fall. The Shrak with the follow-up's done. They're actually going to pick up 2. Disaster or not, this is actually going to be VP grabbing 3 kills in this bottom lane. And as he's going to get himself further away, Ryze with the last swing of his very rare club brings him down. And the Spirits from Mania try and back off Arsad from the lane.
That was well done. I thought CK had enough mana for his extra Reality Rift, but it was on cooldown as well, so... That was unfortunate, losing those heroes. They had a significant advantage in this lane. They still have it. The part of the problem is CK is just such an overwhelmingly strong hero in these lanes, especially against, squishy heroes. You've got Weaver, Leshrac, and Rubick. Like, it's a sad state of affairs when Rubick is one of the tankier heroes in your tri-lane. Illidan, he knows this, and he went straight for a Belt of Strength. He went stats with a Wraith Band, with straight Belt of Strength. He knows he has to have something to survive this burst.
Oh, crazy. Watching him miss move here in the middle lane. Miguel threw down the cogs and he bumped into him twice. And he also just was a little bit too far away for the meld hit to work. It's going to be frustration galore coming out from him.
Honestly, when they saw these lanes from VP, I'm a little bit surprised they didn't throw Darkseer versus Templar Assassin. He does much better versus TA, and Darkseer isn't going to be able to shut down the Omni Knight well enough for it to be worth it. But, I don't know.
At the same time, then you go worry about your top lane. Like, Clockwork to go up against Omni Knight... I suppose it was... okay.
He could still aggressively cogs him away.
Mm-hmm.
But... Either way, it's all about CS game. Either way, they're not going to be getting kills, even if they did switch, unless somebody made a really bad error. So it's going to be all about the CS game, which Darkseer is obviously getting perfect CS.
Yeah.
Which is not a surprise when you skip past the tower.
Now even KSI's realized he's going to be in the position where he can't come in close on that Darkseer. Those Iron Shell damages, it's going to be too much for him.
Well, he can repel.
Yeah, but that's only going to last him so long. He's got level 2 on that repel, but those Iron Shells, they last for a very, very long time. Are they going to try and gank up Illidan on the bottom lane? They need more sentry wards down here. The dewarding battle on the bottom lane was also going on. And now it's the Adaya with the Observer Ward off on the left-hand side and the sentry ward smack bang in the middle of the lane. And they know there's no vision on Illidan. So Ryze kind of has to wait until that Shuki goes, has vision, then Rift and Bolt. At the same time, you're going to have Rubick, who's going to be causing you issues with pickups and such. Crazy with an invis room. Maybe you can pick off Miguel now, because he's right on top of him. So attacks once, actually missed Miguel on the first hit. Attacked a creep instead. So he didn't really follow up. And it looked like he wasn't looking to follow up after that point. After he missed that first hit, it just became a, well, I'm here for fun.
It's all, even if he did hit the initial hit, He would have had some serious balls diving into a tower versus a clockwork with with both battery assault and cogs. That's really just begging for trouble, I feel. But honestly, it might be a little bit too late for Absolute Legends. I mean, Weaver Illidan did the really smart play of picking up that extra bit of stats early on, and now that he has power treads with the stun interruptions from Leshrac and Rubick, I don't think they have enough to kill him.
You're right.
Like, yeah, actually, sure, flat out, if they comboed all of their stuns and were constantly beating on him, but telekinesis, extremely disruptive.
Same
follow
with
up with the Leshrac stun. Yeah.
And then you've got to come in close as well, and Leshrac's walking around with 2 points edict. It's very, very risky. Miguel, man, he's really trying to play around so much here with Crazy. I can't take my eyes off it because I know the second I do, I'm going to miss an amazing play. And Crazy, he's giving this a shot. Meld, it's very, very hard. And that's going to be Miguel. Pops up a DD rune, latches in with its ultimate, but that's still going to be a kill going the way of TA. And that's the reason why my eyes were latched there. Knew the Crazy would not let this lane just go the way it's been going so far.
That was a really good play. Setting up both of the traps, which were necessary to secure the kill, slow him down long enough. But also knowing that Cogs was down, that aggressive Cogs from the clockwork, put him in a really bad position for Templar Assassin to just be able to freely hit him. So, well done picking up that kill, and that's going to win him the lane. He was already winning it through CS. Now he's just going to be dominating it. Top lane is still, you know, a bit of a wash. I mean, Chaos Knight's still getting farm, which is important for Omni Knight. You're never going to get as much farm as Darkseer anyway. Darkseer, Unicorn T is going to be huge with, he's got Mana Boots Bottle and a Soul Ring already. He's got 63 CS in 7.5 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
But that's to be expected. That's within VP's expectations. So,
VP's expectations to be so far ahead of Ryze's farm? Ryze is only about to hit 20 in a lane where Weaver is 37 for 11. This is crazy. And Mania's never going to get his level 6. Like, how many times have we actually been looking at the pool happening? Like, there's a double stack being used right now. But the amount of times I've seen Miracle as well as Mania forced to stay on the lane because they just can't move back. The harassment on CK was stopping from getting any kind of CS. But this creep wave is always, like, it's in this kind of box, which is perfect for VP.
And honestly, I mean, I think the biggest thing is, yeah, maybe Weaver, after you hit level 4, you get those stat items, you get that treads, that's really important. Yeah, maybe he can out-CS Ryze. The bigger thing for me, though, is the fact that the supports are out-leveling AL. They've got a level 5 on one of their supports. They
supports
aren't really
about to
utilizing
die, man.
Their pull.
Crazy with an Invis rune. He's got to choose, Mania or a Miracle. Illidan's going to come down and help him. Maybe they'll choose both. Miracle, 2 hits to kill him off. He's still got the Light Strike Array off of Mania, tethering up to CK, but there's 4 euros diving him, and 2 seconds on the stun. Ryze, nice rift, actually. Pulling him out to safety. Unicorn's still going to be picked up as a level 9 Darkseer that came down to this bottom lane, and it's copying a little bit too much damage from the tower. He's still got 10 stick charges, which he may as well just use right now.
Clockwork.
He's going to hold it. Wait for it. There's your latch, and he goes into Unicorn. He needed a hero on that one that wasn't one of his own teammates, and now, Crazy, he fights up on Miguel. Look at the damage onto Miguel. Meanwhile, Ryze being picked up, ass up, being stunned up. He gets a follow-up onto Miracle, and it's just Crazy's movement. KSI comes, helps him off, drops the hammer on his head. It's still a 2-for-2 at the end of this, but remember the respawns that are still coming off. Crazy goes around the cogs, Unicorn's on the run, and there's the negative armor. They can't decide on one person, they want both. Illidan gets a double kill up this one. TA trap slows down Miguel, and Crazy is, I think he's been told to dive. KSI, there's again that burning cogs of Miguel. They keep him away, but the TA trap goes and Crazy's in. He's got refraction, he needs the vision. Attacks once, Meld, attack twice, Ryze wants to kill him off. 3 seconds on the stun, he's going to get him. This is a huge kill for Ryze to get. He just jumped 2 levels.
Yeah. That was still, though, I mean, even though it probably wasn't necessary for him to go for the clockwork kill there, giving Ryze a kill, that was still a really good team fight for VirtusPro. They have secured, that was the biggest thing I was worried about, was their lanes. The aggro try for me was a little bit worrying. The other option was a suicide lane Omni that's also going to be really, really gimped. They've really exceeded my expectations, and now they're looking really, really well. I mean, 9 to 11, 10.5 minutes in, Illidan's already got treads, Ring of Akilla, and now a Ring of Health. Omni-Knight's fully leveled out. He's got maxed repel and max purification. He's looking really, really strong. You know, he's probably, I mean, I'm interested to see the item pickups on him. If he's going to go full on mobility with like a four staff, which is really helpful for Omni-Knight, or if he's going to focus on just team fight with mech.
I would have said mech, but that ring which is on NS at this point has me guessing. It really has me guessing, but he's not finding anywhere near farm. No, it's going to be Omni-Knight. None of the other supports are finding enough farm. There's a repel up on KSI. What's Wisp and Miguel now going to do? They can't do anything to him.
Mm-hmm.
He just stands his ground, and repel comes off cooldown almost instantly. And they're trying to give levels to Mania, but Mania is getting nothing in that middle lane. He's got to come back down the bottom lane. They still haven't found this level 6, but if they do, like, what are they going to do? Gank up crazy on the top lane? That's their only option. They can't kill off KSI. KSI will pop Repel and ulti. Now they're going to go on Illidan. There's a Sentry Wall for the Radiant side. Lashrak stun goes on to NS. We're going to follow up Telekinesis stun. They're going to pick up Mani, even though he is level 6. Laguna Blade flies out, and now what was stolen. 4 points Bolt, but no mana for it. Support plus Weaver lost in the bottom lane for the price of a Wisp. Who still won't care because he still popped over the level 6 when they got the kills on bottom lane.
And Chaos Knight is probably going to go back or not. I thought he was going to go back, but it looks like they might try and go for the Rubick here, who's still sticking around. But Wisp is actually going to teleport to him. They don't have the opportunity just yet, but with Darkseer and Clockwork, very, very aggressive heroes because they're so tanky, they have some escape mechanisms. They can easily spy out that single hero that is too overextended in his lane and pick him off with the Wisp teleport.
Look what VP's doing, though. Everyone goes down, not everyone, but the three of them are grouping up to get on the bottom. Yeah, everyone. That's what I was waiting for. Everyone to come to the bottom lane. But, okay, yep. Wisp has ulti. Who cares? We have a 4-point Chaos Bolt, the just stunned up Ryze, a Latrak follow-up stun, the Tether's still making life a little bit more difficult, and Ryze is almost dead. Oh, the cogs! Bump him out, Mania's ulti will take him back to base, took nobody else with him. It would have been good if he took the CK with him, but he couldn't get the job done. And Illidan keeps chasing down, chasing after Miguel. Battery of Somnies, they got to keep their distance a little bit more. Nice! Back into the Slave, and a rocket from Clockwork to finish the job. At the same time, Wisp, his ulti did return him. And Crazy with a DD rune. Oh, look at the damage on Miracle! Repel is up on Crazy, and he might need to purify too. 4 second Chaos Bolt goes off again from NS, locking Miguel in position. Trying to ulti himself down to Crazy. TP going up from Ryan, so he will get back to base safely. Miguel won't be as lucky. Miracle definitely won't be, or maybe he will be. There's the ulti from KSI. It's like, Illidan, just please dive. Kill off that support. How much commitment can you do? Miguel's being tossed around like a clockwork on the other side. And it's 13-15, VirtusPro. That seems so much harder than it probably should have been.
Yeah. Yeah, honestly, that was a really well-executed team fight by Absolute Legends. They had a lot of really great plays there. Unfortunately, it didn't come out. You know, some 5-man Dota from VirtusPro. It's very, very strong versus Wisp. They have the Omni-Knight. Obviously, that's a significant advantage there. When he has mech, it's going to be even bigger. So that's huge. Really well done, Absolute Legends. They're going to have to focus on their split pushing now and only come in to defend these towers. It's the main use of Wisp Ultimate. From now on out is going to be just split pushing, and when they have to defend, when a unicorn is ready to hit a big wall with his vacuum and that sort of thing, then they can go in. But otherwise, they're just going to be trying to trade towers where they can.
Mm-hmm. I'm hoping this build from Illidan is what I think it is. He starts with a Mithril Hammer. I'm really hoping it's Deso and not just the BKB, considering they've already got Repel. Just let Illidan do his damage. Clockwork, really, Miguel? This is some serious confidence. Pick up throw down, wonderful wall, and better cogs! Miguel just destroys him! Unicorn's on the other side, it's 4 on the sidelines, and they want to kill off Crazy. Crazy wants Mania, and he picks him up too. But a 2 second stun out, he can refract up. The drum charge has already been popped, a TA trap to try and slow him down. Unicorn Surge will last him a decent time, it's 2 points up on that one. And Crazy gets himself far enough away, maybe not. Meld, never got it off. There was no gem, there was no sentry. Possibly could have just melted out of that one. But 18-18 and Clockwork. I thought it was suicide, man. I thought it was suicide.
Oh, man. Those two heroes combined, it's just amazing what they can get accomplished. That was so unbelievable. Unicorn, beautiful vacuum. Great wall. I mean, instantly wiped out three heroes. It was just the really tanky Templar Assassin with Repel on, and then Weaver trying to run around, get some kills, ended up going down. That's exactly what Absolute Legends needed. They needed some sort of really good team fight that's going to buy them more time for Ryze to be able to get some more levels in. Phantasm level 2 is going to be coming up soon. Mania, the more levels he has in Tether, the better. And what else? Do they have any big items? Did they just pick up that mech? I believe they did on Unicorn.
Yeah, that wasn't there for the last fight.
No.
I'm guessing
First Pro, they might want to wait for their own mech, honestly.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be difficult for VP to fight here. There's a sentry ward plus the tower in the middle lane. And they had to know the sentry ward was there. Unicorn, you can see him again. He walked up there and put his little paws up in the air thinking, yep, I can get it back. Unicorn, wow, crazy. Blink dagger jump with the meld hit. Lina's life points just don't exist when that kind of stuff happens. The defensive cogs are down. That kind of holds Crazy back behind that tower. But at the same time, look at bottom lane. Mania as well as CK can come at a moment's notice, but they take a tier 1 tower. Completely unfazed by the world and everything going on in it. Are they ulting? They're ulting.
Awkward, yep.
They'll come in. Wait for the jump in by the CK, so they're in the middle of it all. Laguna Blade is enough to kill off NS in range of the tower. CK and Wisp, they're the ones following down to Riyar Rift. They end up getting that kill at the back end of play. And now over towards Unicorn. Unicorn, he's actually alive on 99 life points. As KSI gets bumped away, it's a triple kill for Ryze. I still can't believe they've only lost the leader in this one. Ryze is a bolt in 1 second time. This is amazing fights, and KSI walks in. Drops the heal, Crazy comes off, he wants Ryze's life points, but then Ryze, there's just too many Ryze. KSI's on the run out, Tether comes back in again, Ryze on very still, very, very low life, and finally is brought down. Crazy will take it, Miguel's not making this easy for him. In fact, Miguel gets a revenge kill out. And Mania will continue to hold his hand. And it's 23 to 22 now in this middle lane.
Well done. I mean, Absolute Legends, these team fights have been amazing.
Oh, buyback.
VP.
TP, but look at the cog position. It's perfect to burn him off. And he can't blink because he also took the damage. Now he can blink. Stun onto Miguel. Big, big stun for Arsad to land. Guessing the kill, revenge on the clockwork. And now they can finish up the tier 1 tower in the middle lane. And get back what CK and Wiz stole from them on the bottom lane. Or can they? Laguna Blade's already back off cooldown. So Slave will fly, Unicorn with the vac. No Iron Shell, but he gets picked up. Miracle. Oh, Unicorn. He's actually in a lot of trouble. Clockwork has to buy back. The double TP's coming this middle lane. Illidan, he couldn't time-lapse himself out. He got stunned up, and the Laguna Blade finished him off. And now Ryze surging him up. He's got the Iron Shell on him, too. That surge can last a little bit longer. Miguel going to latch up a little bit faster. And now he's going to go for Arsad. Whoop, back in again. The cogs are still here. The Lost Rack stun again from Arsad. Perfect positioning until he gets backed in. 2 second stun, back, and the wall is back up again from the Darkseer. They're looking for another kill. CK goes down the left-hand side of the screen. Then over towards the Wisp. Can Unicorn as well as Mania get themselves away from this one? The blink down by TA. Mania tethers back up and away. He gets back up to Miracle. He just completely bypassed the VP lineup while Unicorn, he wants to chase KSI, but no, he goes into the middle lane and joins up with Miracle. Doesn't want to chase in too far. There's a blink in by the TA. He's looking for the extra. Miguel got back. Still can't believe the Wisp. He's actually back at base safely. Back in the middle lane. The Weaver Wave flies out. Managed to latch up there on Unicorn. KSI body blocking him. Two levels up in that D-Gen aura. Not making this easy to get away. And then the heal plus the extra attacks coming off with the bugs to help out. This fight just doesn't want to end. They will take the tier 1 tower in the middle lane. So I'm assuming now actually it will end. VP will fall back.
And Toby finally gets a breather. Man, that was a long team fight. Wow. So a couple of things, man. VP, they did the right thing. And they've been doing the right thing with these team fights. They're really chaotic back and forth team fights that are really hard for Absolute Legends to place, right? So if it's a 5-on-5 full engagement, here's my team, here's your team, we're gonna run at the tower, we're gonna try and defend it. It's really easy for your AL to win that team fight because of wall, vacuum, clockwork. I mean, we saw it before. VP, they're trying to get a lot more overly aggressive with some heroes and then play play passive with others. Crazy's getting really far in trying to pick off support heroes.
Miguel wanted to jump in on Roshan just then when it was being done, but I don't know if you saw Arsar's positioning, it was beautiful. He was body blocking it out, and now they jump in. Repel on Crazy. Who needs a BKB when you do this kind of stuff? Illidan, he got one of the bugs on Mania, but he just tethers himself away. The attack almost enough to kill him off. 40 HP, the Meg Charge will pop. TA with another great trap. Slowing down three heroes. VirtusPro are going to count themselves very unlucky they didn't pick off the Wisp just then. Ghost Scepter for the win, huh? Sort of.
Yeah, that Ghost Scepter pickup is going to be huge for him. I mean, from here on out, we just saw how effective it was being able to dodge that. That damage hit was so big. So if the longer he can live in these team fights, the better the team fights are going to go for absolute legends. Being able to constantly bottle heal on Ryze, he's going to be a really tanky hero that's going to be very hard to deal with. You're going to see him pick up a BKB from not too long, and with the way these team fights are going, 16 really isn't that far away. With these chaotic team fights, with a lot of kills back and forth, it really overinflates the amount of experiences in the pool. Heroes killing heroes is a lot more than heroes killing creeps. So they're going to get level 16 very, very quickly, and that's an advantage to Absolute Legends. The fact that they're still sticking in these team fights and doing decently well, even though this balls-out aggression from VP is hard to deal with, it's going to put them in a really good position for the mid-game, right? That 25 to 30-minute mark, they're going to be looking okay. VP, they're trying to force a lot of things with this five-man Dota because of they're afraid of this Wiz kind of snowballing and that sort of thing. BP, I think they're going to be in a position soon where once it hits that 25-minute mark, 30-minute mark, they've taken some of these towers. Honestly, I think they should back up and try and get in some farm.
I mean, think opposite, man.
Advantage of the Aegis.
I say screw to backing up. Get yourself in there. Fight like dogs. They're going to say it's five. They've got to go in. Give it a shot. Repel is up. Illidan's looking healthy. He's got an Aegis and a Deso. That tier 2 tower shouldn't stand a chance. CK and Wisp having a great old time on the long lane. I'll give her a shot, and oh, is that actually a call to go around? It looks like it is. They're asking him to almost smoke up and go around the line. Now VP won't care about that. They want to go straight in. Edict damage, clockwork, latches in. There goes your wall already from the Darksteer. He needs to back him back in and go, and nice life strike array almost was. Support will be there, and the heal came up very, very quickly. Even the ulti coming up from Omni-Lite, and CK and Wisp, they're caught on the wrong side of the river right now. It's going to be Ryze. Can he get any more out right now? He's got a Reality Rift, and they're taking a lot of damage. They just hold him there. Miguel again splits up the fight with the cogs. It's a 2-for-1. Miguel, that Sideblade damage was actually doing a lot of damage to Miracle on the way out too. Not to mention the Desolator hit that keeps coming up from the Weaver throughout this entire fight. The Rubik being lost for a CK Wisp, and Clockwork's not looking too healthy either. And Crazy blinks down. He's just waiting for Miracle. There goes your meld hit. Two attacks, Light Strike Array, unaffecting the repelled up Crazy. And a tier 2 tower is lost on the top.
Yeah. Well done taking tier 2 like that. I mean, that's the chaos of those team fights, right? I mean, Chaos Knight came in, and again, they teleport in the far back. The only hero they can really kill is that Lestrak, who wasn't in range of the Omni Knight. He hasn't been in the range of these Omni Knight Guardian Angels. So AL, they're trying to play these chaotic team fights and trying to do what they can, picking off, you know, some of the only heroes they can because they're so spread out that they have some sort of advantage when Omni Knight ults that they can pick off one or two heroes. But it's just too much. They forced the wall. VP went forward. Clockwork jumped in, they forced the wall, but they did a really good job, right? Crazy went forward, he slowed down the Darksteer to keep him from being able to get a really strong vacuum. He still got a decent one, but it wasn't good enough. He got aggressive on them, and then they all backed out as a team, away from the wall, focused on the Wisp and the CK. Really well done all around. I mean, the movement from this team is just really keeping AL on their toes, and it's very hard to hit those really good walls and force those good team fights around it like this when this aggression and this movement from VP just is all over the place.
Well, all over the place is now going to be in one place. Middle lane. TP's coming in from the last player from VP, so Arsar coming back to that middle lane. All five going to group up for this. While Darksteer is giving a lot of momentum towards that top lane. CK Wisp having good times on the bottom. Tier 2 tower in the mid lane is the focus. Miracle's actually a bigger focus. Again, these cogs from Miguel split up the fight. The Ghost Scepter also means they cannot attack there on Miracle. And Illidan took a lot of damage from the tower, but he'll heal up. He's basically out of mana. He's completely out of mana. The Tier 2 tower will take a fall. That is Arcane boosting a pot from NS. There we go. They need another set. They got one on NS, they got one on KSI, and Illidan still finds himself with no mana, but all life. Aegis Immortal, how long has that thing got? It's actually under a minute now. So it looks like 26-20, and that Aegis Immortal will be reclaimed. Crazy. Just walk straight in. There's a Desolator effect on the Tier 3 tower. They're trying to force CK Wiz to come back. The VAC, the wall, it picks up two. Clockwork lights up, actually locks himself onto one of the illusions. Picks up Thrawmage, the other side of his cogs. Illidan again, burnt completely out of mana. Crazy, was inside the base and walks his way back out again. The Fae Bolt will clean up the illusions. The CK Wiz still haven't joined them. Ryze and Mane are having a great old time on the bottom lane. Ryze with his BKB up and running and drums. He'll come back when the time is right. And the time being right when the Tier 2 tower goes down.
Yeah, the time being right for VirtusPro is when that wall is down. But that Aegis is almost down. They have to either go in now, burn the Aegis right away while the wall is down, or probably just back, and there goes the Aegis.
Yep.
So Illidan's at a little bit of disadvantage. Jump They're going to go in anyway, though.
They go on Miguel. What a fact. Into the cogs. They got four people caught in that. Then goes the Guardian Angel. KSI is trying to keep Ennis alive. They did pick up the Clockwork Goblin. The Unicorn slowed down. In fact, stopped at the end of that one. Damn, you're going to love that Diffusal Blade to stop the Surge out. And there goes the Tier 3 tower. CK Wister never came back. They need the buybacks in order to do so. The Tier 2 tower did go down the bottom lane, but losing Arrakis is more important. Losing Miracle, also just as important. They come in close. TA takes it. There's CK whispering through the rear. They get another back, pulling VirtusPro in together. CK able to get one kill. Can he keep going? The BKB is going to be long charge timing on that one. Holding KSI there. Now he gets the heal off. Ryze will go down. Absolute legends. They attempted it, but that 5-on-5 fight from VP, especially after the tower went down, it was just too strong, and they may be able to take out the top tier 3. I don't know about Rax, but they can look at the top tier 3.
Yeah, that's the problem with this Omni Knight. It's such a well-executed strategy that AL, they tried to bait out the Guardian Angel, right? But they were still able to pick up two kills. They were able to kill the Clockwork and the Darkseer, and they couldn't come in. Like, they can't teleport in with that Wisp because the Guardian Angel lasts too long. By that time, by the time it's actually down, Wisp is just seconds away from teleporting back out, and that's a big loss for that Chaos Knight. So, just really good drafting all around by VP. And with that two racks, honestly, they could just back up, wait for the next Roshan, play it safe if they want to, and finish off the rest of the farm. I mean, they've still been picking up items left and right, which is kind of surprised me. The Absolute Legends, especially with the Wisp Chaos Knight split pushing, that they haven't been able to keep up in items. I mean, you look at that CK, he just has nothing. He is BKB, that's it.
Mm-hmm. Life is really difficult for the CK, and that's with a CK who, he didn't have a great start. And I say that after AL took a 4v1 fight, I say he didn't have a good start. But he didn't. He lost out in the farm. The items never came. The high levels, it took some time until they finally got one of a secondary big fight in that bottom lane. It just wasn't there. And VP, they're on the final march. They're looking to take out their bottom racks and go straight for the GG and be one game up right now. And they know the pressure's on them. They definitely know the pressure's on them. In this group stage, they are not looking fantastic. They are in the second position, but they're tied with Next.KZ at 1-1 apiece. And you've got four games. You've got four games to get these points. Five people per group. And you've got to get the best result you possibly can and get that number one position, which at this point, in Group B, which is the group we're watching right now, it belongs to IC Cup. Unicorn going to look to try and fight this one. Three levels up on his ultimate. There goes Clockwork. Cogs, they go off. Back and back into that wall. And there you go. There's your back into the pop. But up onto the high ground. Ryze, Unicorn. The TA trying to give it a shot. Ominid has to buy himself back into this game. He's TPing the Tier 2 tower. It's going to take him a long time before he gets there, but both BKBs, Ryze as well as the one that's up on Azar, the Lashrak, popped off. And TA, he was able to pop that Clockwork Goblin. Never even saw that Daedalus coming.
Yeah. The whole reason that they even traded there, they traded one for one with the wall down. That's not a good sign.
Oh,
but the whole reason that happened, Guardian Angel didn't go off.
Unicorn's gone. Unicorn is so gone. Crazy just in through the rear, killing off support heroes. The Ghost Head will let him live. The VAC, which was stolen by the Rubik, actually pulled both the Wisp as well as the CK back down again. So CK will go down. The bottom tier 3 tower will go down. And this will probably be now the GG call coming off from Absolute Legends. In fact, there it is from Mania. He accepts a defeat. Miguel says, nope, one last hurrah. And his hurrah was very, very cut short. But full race goes down. This is a best of two in the series, guys. So I say best of two. It's a two-game series, as all the group stage matches are. So VP and AL. AL will have a chance for revenge. And VP will have a chance to take number one spot in the group stage. That's what's coming up in just a couple of moments' time. I say a couple of moments because VP... You can see just through the amount of damage which is done to these tier 4 towers, how much damage there was during this team fight. Throughout all these team fights. In fact, it was 27 to 38 at the end of the game. What I really want to see, Capitalist, from the next game, is watching VP not ban the Wisp again. Make a statement and say, we do not care about the Wisp. And it'll be such a big statement to make as well. Because there's so many teams out there that really have to get to that point where they don't fear the Wisp. It's the only way, really, Well, then again, there will be changes in the new meta, and we'll see if the Wisp does change up. But he didn't really change that much. What, spirits don't give the proper vision? Who cares? That's not what Wisp brings. It's more than that. But yeah, we'll see. We'll see if VP want to play, I'm not going to say Russian roulette, if they actually want to play Texas Hold'em poker and leave the Wisp as a card that's still down. You'll find out. Stay tuned. We'll be back here for our final game of the evening.
I said good day, sir!